Hello friends, today we are here to discuss metacognition, one of the very important points while discussing neuro-linguistic programming. So while going ahead, it is very important to know what is metacognition and what is the role of metacognition in neuro-linguistic programming, how it is important while discussing neuro-linguistic programming. In fact, it is really difficult to define metacognition sometime, because metacognition is simply defined as thinking about thinking. That is to say, knowing your own wisdom or knowing your own potential or caliber. The term metacognition has been part of neuro-linguistic programming as the very concept of metacognition reflects on cognitive experiences. Cognitive experience means your brain functioning. So the very subject of metacognition is highly debatable regarding its subject matter, because it is related to psychology. Metacognition is defined as cognition about cognition, or knowing about knowing, a skill and the knowledge to explain the depth of one's caliber. Means my caliber. How I am going to deal with a particular situation, maybe that is my potential to explore myself, and in that case we may say that to some extent it is metacognition. Now in metacognition, meta means beyond. This aspect includes knowledge about when and how to use particular strategies for learning or for problem solving. Now, what are these problems? We can divide metacognition into two components if we talk about problem. The first is knowledge about cognition, and the second is regulation of cognition. Now, knowledge about cognition, what is this? I mean, knowledge about cognition, how would you explain it? This is about your own caliber. This is about your own thinking. Now, it is John Flavel, the American psychologist, who coined the term metacognition in 1976. And metacognition is classified into three components. The first is metacognitive knowledge, also called metacognitive awareness, and it is what individuals know about themselves and others as cognitive processors. Second is metacognitive regulation. It is the regulation of cognition and learning experiences through a set of activities that help people control their own learning. Third, metacognitive experiences are those experiences that have something to do with the current ongoing cognitive endeavor. Now, three types of metacognitive awareness. Declarative knowledge. What is declarative knowledge? It stands for knowledge about oneself as a learner and about what factors can influence one's performance. Declarative knowledge can also be referred to as world knowledge. So this is about declarative knowledge, means knowledge about oneself as learner. Second is procedural knowledge. This indicates towards the fact that knowledge is about doing things. This type of knowledge is displayed as heuristics and is a strategy, heuristic strategies. A high degree of procedural knowledge can allow individuals to perform tasks more automatically. Now, this is achieved through a large variety of strategies that can be accessed more efficiently. Third is conditional knowledge, which refers to knowing when and why. to use declarative and procedure knowledge. It allows students to allocate their resources when using strategies. So this in turn allows the strategies to become more effective. Now, levels of regulation of cognition. Because knowledge of cognition and regulation of cognition, the two aspects of metacognition. Now, what are the levels of regulation of cognition? First is planning, which refers to the appropriate selection of strategies and the correct allocation of resources that affect task performance. Monitoring refers to one's awareness of comprehension and task performance, and this is the second level of regulation of cognition. The third level of regulation of cognition is evaluating, and which refers to appraising the final product of a task and the efficiency at which the task was performed. This can include re-evaluating strategies that were used. Now, in the words of Teller, 1999, metacognition is an appreciation of what one already knows, together with a correct apprehension of the learning task and what knowledge and skills it requires, combined with the agility to make correct inferences about how to apply one's strategic knowledge to a particular situation and to do so efficiently and reliably. Now, according to some psychologists, metacognition is referred to as one's inner language, or as thinking about one's own thinking, or metacognition refers to an individual's self-knowledge about their cognition as well as to the ability to be able to influence one's own cognition. Research on metacognition has strong possibilities and opportunities to influence our understanding of learning strategies for students, means for the learners with learning disabilities. A strategy is a systematic thought or approach which allows us to get from one point to another. And metacognition is a kind of a strategy which will give you this power to point out or to explore the faculty, the power in within you to apply on a particular task. That is metacognition. Now, the goal of a strategy is to teach students how to become purposeful, effective, independent learners. This is the goal of metacognition. Because when we give training of NLP to the students, we try to bring out the best out of that student. Now, metacognition is one of the strategies to handle one of the important potential power to handle the situation. Now, self-assessment and self-monitoring are thought to enhance strategic functioning. So, when we talk of metacognition, these two part, self-assessment, how much wisdom you have, what is the caliber, and self-monitoring, when you are pursuing a task, where you are, what you are doing. So, self-monitoring are thought to enhance a strategic functioning. Metacognitive strategy training should be incorporated into the regular language teaching program to help students to making the learning process more effective. When we talk of metacognition or neuro-linguistic programming, it is more or less personality development, enhancing your personality. And when we talk of personality enhancement, it is communication. And it is effective communication. Now, metacognition is one of the strategies to help the learners to learn the better way how to go for effective communication. Among the various cognitive systems and cognitive structures, one of them happens to be the system of language, and it is one of the many systems entering into an array of interconnected cognitive structure. So, language means not only the verbal language, cognitive language, your non-verbal language. So, how you perceive people, that how he or she thinks, what is there in the mind. So, language is also one of the systems that take place in the mind only. We all know, I mean linguistically, that language has again twofold, that is the abstract language and the concrete language. So, abstract is already in the mind and we use as per the context. How to use it as per the context, that is the contextual communication, very important, and metacognition is a kind of a strategy which help us to decide that how to use that contextual language or communication. Language is a part of mental organ, we all know, I mean this is what I said, that abstract and the concrete. The abstract is always there in your mind and concrete that we actually use. So, a study of the mental process is involved in the comprehension, production, acquisition of language. And a number of psycholinguistics work has been devoted to the learning of language by children and on speech processing and comprehension by both children and adults. Traditional areas of research include language production, language comprehension, language acquisition, language disorder, language and thought, and neurocognition, an area of study which draws from linguistics and psychology, focuses upon the comprehension and production of language and comprising the very part of neurolinguistic programming. As a result, psycholinguists who have a background of training in both linguistics and psychology have been attempting since early 1960s to gain a better understanding of how the abstract rules which determine human language are acquired and used to communicate appropriately created meaningful messages from one person to another via the vocal auditory medium. Research has been directed to the evolutionary development of language, the biological basis of language, the nature of the sound system, the rules of syntax, the nature of meaning, and the process of language acquisition. A study of innate behavior approach to learn language is metacognition. Now, aspects of metacognition, because we were talking about the various strategies of metacognition. Metacognition is a kind of a strategy. So, what are the aspects? Now, there are three important aspects of metacognition. The first is self-awareness, the second is language are acquired, and third is preparation and planning for effective learning. So, the first is self-awareness, and this particular stage refers to know one's learning style. When a learner knows their individual learning style, they can take measures which will enable them to process the information more efficiently. If a student knows that they have loose concentration or memory is weak, he or she will also be aware of how to develop this by note taking and studying the notes. The second step explains more about how languages are acquired. Language acquisition is a delicate process that involves both knowing information and knowing how to utilize it. If students believe that by merely attending classes they will learn the language, it stands to reason that they will not reach their objective. But if the students are aware of the fact that it is necessary to participate actively in the class, to get involved and take part in every activity, they will have a greater chance of being effective and successful. The third and the final step is the stage of preparation and planning for effective learning. The setting of learning goals is rather crucial because learners will attain the very objective more easily if they have clearly stated what these are. Now, looking these three aspects of metacognitive learning, we can analyze it further, dividing into four important segments. What are these segments? First, selection of appropriate learning strategies. Knowing your limitations, try to find out which one is more appropriate while learning a particular task. Monitoring strategy use. While selecting one strategy or applying it while learning a task, try to monitor it. Is it fruitful? Is it useful while pursuing a task? Orchestrating various strategies and evaluating strategy use and learning. Now, the above mentioned strategies, all these strategies can be adopted by the trainer according to the need of the student. For example, somebody needs monitoring strategy use, somebody needs orchestrating various strategy. Now, selection of appropriate learning strategy. A student can assume, or a learner can assume, that he, she actually wants while learning language. What she actually want? The trainer can promote this reflection by being explicit about the particular learning goals they have set for the class and guiding the students in setting their own learning goals. If the goal is clearly articulated, it will be easier for the learners to measure their progress. And the trainer might set a goal for the students of getting command over the vocabulary from a particular chapter in the textbook. Now, a student too may set a goal for himself of being able to answer the comprehension questions at the end of the chapter. Now, researchers have suggested that teaching readers how to use a specific reading strategy is a prime consideration in the reading classroom. The metacognitive ability to select and use particular strategy in a given context for a specific purpose means that the learner can think and make conscious decisions about the learning process. Now, to be effective, metacognitive instructions should explicitly teach students a variety of learning strategies and also when to use them. This is very important for a trainer as well as a student. One possible strategy is word analysis. Now, for example, dividing the word into its prefix and the stem. Another possible strategy is the use of context clues to help guess the meaning of a word. But a student must receive explicit instruction in how to use these strategies, and they need to know that no single strategy will work in every instance. Teachers or trainer should show them how to choose the strategy that has the best chance of success in a given situation. Next is monitoring strategy use. By monitoring their use of learning strategies, students or the learners feel better to keep themselves on track to meet their learning goal. Once they have selected and begun to implement a specific strategies, they need to ask themselves periodically whether or not they are still using those strategies as intended. Now, for example, students may be taught that an effective writing strategy involves thinking about their audience and their purpose in writing. That is to explain, to persuade. Now, students can be taught that to monitor their use of a strategy, they should pause occasionally while writing to ask themselves questions about what they are doing, such as whether or not they are providing the right amount of background information for their intended audience and whether the examples they are using are effective in supporting their purpose. Orchestrating various strategies. While learning language, I mean this is the third level, while learning language, a learner has to face various difficulties. Now, to cope with these, one has to apply various theories, which are the combination of a strategy. This theory is called orchestrating various strategies, that is the use of more than one strategy. This method is an important metacognitive skill. The ability to coordinate, organize and make association among the various strategies available is a major distinction between a strong and weak, I mean second language learner or anything that you are trying to learn. Now the trainer can assist students by making them aware or alert of multiple strategies available to them, for example by training them how to use both word analysis and context clues to determine the meaning of an unfamiliar word. That is the pragmatic aspect of learning language. Now the teacher also needs to show students how to recognize when one strategy is not working and how to move on to another. This is very important where a learner is faulty. For example, a student may try to use word analysis to determine the meaning of the word antimony. Having recognized anti as a prefix meaning against, but that strategy won't work in this instance. Anti is not a prefix here. Antimony is a metallic chemical element that has nothing to do with being against or opposed to something. So when the student finds the word analysis does not help her figure out what this word means, she needs to know how to turn to other strategies such as context clues to help her to understand the word. Now, next strategy for use and learning and evaluation. So, we are discussing pursuing or learning the foreign language. So, second language learners are actively involved in metacognition when they attempt to evaluate whether what they are doing is effective. Teachers or trainer can help a student evaluate their strategy use by asking them to respond thoughtfully to these questions. What am I trying to learn? What strategies am I using? How efficiently am I using them? What other way could I do? So these are the pertinent questions to know the effective way to learn. While responding to these four questions, a student gets reflection of all the previous aspects of metacognition, allowing the second language learner to reflect through the cycle of learning. Preparing and planning relates to identifying what is to be accomplished while selecting and using particular strategies relate to the question of which strategies are being used. Now, for example, while teaching the specific reading skill of main idea comprehension, the teacher can help the students evaluating their strategy by using the four questions. First, focusing on the main idea of the text, the teacher can motivate the student to find out the real task or the understanding of the text clearly, planning to explore the main idea. The teacher can persuade the readers to know the acquired planning and to identify the main idea, knowing and purposefulness of the strategy. Now, research shows that learners whose skills or knowledge bases are weak in a particular area tend to overestimate their ability in that particular area. Now, in other words, they don't know enough to recognize that they lack sufficient knowledge for accurate self-assessment. In contrast, learners whose knowledge or skills are strong may underestimate their ability. Now, these high ability learners don't recognize the extent of their knowledge or skills. Now, Kruger and Danny's research also show that it is possible to teach learners at all ability levels to assess their own performance more accurately. So, the interactions of metacognitive skills, learning language is an individual task also, and it varies from person to person. At the same time, metacognition is not a linear process that moves from preparing and planning to evaluating. More than one metacognitive process may be occurring at a time during a second language learning task. And this highlights once again how the orchestration of various strategy is a vital component of second language learning. Similarly, maintaining motivation to see a task to completion is also a metacognitive skill. The ability to become aware of distracting stimuli, both internal and external, and sustain effort over time also involves metacognitive or executive functions. So, the theory that metacognition has a critical role to play in successful learning means it is important that it be demonstrated by both students and teacher. So, students, we have seen that how metacognition is important. Because neuro-linguistic programming gives you a power to assess yourself. Why assessing yourself? To get the best out of your potentials. Now, metacognition is one of the power to get out the best potentials. We have discussed while discussing neuro-linguistic programming that how to use resources. For that, flexibility is required. While persuading a task, maybe that we fail, and that particular strategy through which we are pursuing a particular program may not click. Now, in that direction or in that situation, what else could be done? If you are flexible, if you know how to exploit other resources, you go for other resource and apply it, the strategy, and if the work is done, you will get success. So, metacognition is very important to assess yourself, to know your limitations as well as your plus point. And you can do that whether through introspection, through practicing, through discussion, and through other things. So, once you know yourself, once you can locate your lacuna or limitations, you can go for other resources, other strategy that may lead you to the path of success. In that way, metacognition is a very, very important part of neuro-linguistic programming as well as for those who are learning new things. I have given you the example of second language learning or any foreign languages. Even for that, you need a kind of motivation. So, how to persuade yourself to learn a foreign language? You need to apply various theories or various strategy. That is why I mentioned orchestration. Orchestration theory means as there are wires in orchestra and the wire which switch to a particular context. Similarly, the qualities which you have and which quality is useful for a particular context. With these words, I would like to conclude and try to understand metacognition with the help of knowing yourself and with the help of trying, doing effort. That is the best way to know yourself. Keep on doing efforts to move ahead in the life, and you will know yourself better. Thank you.